let's play out the latest statement from the Siddaramaiah camp. His son has spoken up amid reports that the former chief minister is trailing.
He'll be leading back in this
Congress. Congress and will CM Siddaramaiah go to with JDS? Or have you got it?
See, right now we are hoping that Congress would form a government on its own. So if at all that doesn't happen, then it's up to the senior leaders to decide what to do. I don't want to comment on those. From all the constituency, our local leaders and karyakartas, they are giving us feedback. According to them, we should be the single largest party and we should get a simple majority.
So whichever way this goes, I'm looking at the 2013 numbers. The BJP had 40 seats. The trends are showing that they may be getting upwards of 92-93. So that's more than doubling their tally.
Absolutely. But the last time was when the Yedurappa actually
had left. And there left, was
and he took away 10% of the votes.
Yes, party. But for all those who said that this is not a wave election, there is no Modi wave, Yedurappa may be back, but the Lingayat vote has been split and so on and so forth. The BJP is doubled
its tally. As you were pointing out, that the BJP is non-existent south of Karnataka. But the fact that the BJP is leading in 82 seats right now, it means that they have done a... It's like a good saturated performance. You know, that's what it indicates to, that in certain areas, they have really done well.
An interesting piece of research. We spoke about the rallies and the road travel. Prime Minister Modi covered a distance of 19,281 kilometers. Rahul Gandhi traveled more than 34,000 kilometers. And Amit Shah, who is the architect of this campaign, did more than 41,000 kilometers. Mr. Sudesh Verma, many have said that this also showed the sign of desperation. Prime Minister Modi was not scheduled to address so many rallies, but he ended up towards the last phase. He may have converted some people over to the BJP, but it also showed that the BJP's own assessment was that till the very end, they weren't doing as well as they wanted to.
It would be wrong to say so, because you see, we had our own strategy, and Prime Minister has these addresses, rallies depending on the need of the party, because everyone who is contesting wants that the Prime Minister should address one rally, at least in that district. At least we should have done much more, because we could not reach to all districts, only 21 rallies he addressed, because he is our USP, he is our most charismatic leader. And when he speaks, people actually know that he is going to implement his vision of Sabka Saath, Sabka Vikas. So there is no harm in making the Prime Minister campaign as much as he can. And nobody should have a grudge over this, because we are not importing a leader from Italy. We are not importing from any place. He is the BJP. The BJP, it belongs to him. He belongs to the BJP. And we are proud of this fact. So why should one grudge?
But you know, Sudesh, the argument cuts both ways. Yes, he is your leader. You can monetize him wherever you want to. But the fact of the matter is that it also reflects overt dependence of a cadre-based, cadre-supported party like Bharatiya Janata Party on one person. And this is not as if it has happened in the past. This is happening for the first time in the history of BJP after, you know, it was formed in 1980.
Karthike, you have been covering the BJP for a very long time and you are an expert on the party, I know. But you also know that close to 35 national leaders of the BJP campaigned in their own way, including the various chief ministers. They came, they campaigned, they were given a lot of coverage in the local media. But yes, when the Prime Minister comes, the entire focus is on him. It's not that others did not campaign. And it happens every time you have one big leader, like Atal Bihari Vajpayee was one big leader, everybody wanted to have his rallies. Today it is Modi ji, tomorrow it may be someone else. This is the character of the party. But the entire cadre works together to convert that mass appeal into votes. Without such a huge cadre support, you cannot translate that into vote.
You know, you stay with me, Sudesh, you know, going back to Adil. You know, Adil, my question to you is that the sort of performance of Mr. Gandhi, the sort of campaign he did, the number of mathas he visited, it was all received very well. But Adil, but when it comes to pinching the election, taking away the election, you know, it does not happen. He campaigned very well in Gujarat, but you know, he could not turn around the state. He has campaigned extremely well in Karnataka, but the leads are showing otherwise. Is there something lacking in the larger strategy? You campaign well, but the state doesn't come to you. Yeah, absolutely, after this. Yes, Adil.
Karthikeya ji, despite the figures, the initial trends being 83 to 79, and despite the Congress party being the incumbent party in power, the fight is extremely close. So I think let's not prejudge the situation. The Congress president led from the front. We are hopeful for a victory. And the people of Karnataka, we sincerely believe that the people of Karnataka will not accept the Yeti Reddy gang. The Yeti Reddy gang is synonymous with corruption. And Mr. Sudesh Verma was talking about the Prime Minister being their most favoured leader. That's an internal issue of the BJP. But the Congress party is concerned when the Prime Minister abdicates his basic duty here at the centre and governance goes into paralysis mode. When that happens, the Congress party is seriously concerned.
Yes, Prakash, you wanted to ask a question to Sudesh.
Mr. Verma, I'm Prakash from Bangalore. My question is, it is true that Mr. Modi's campaign swung a lot of votes in the BJP's favor in the last 10 days, which means with all that, if you're still neck and neck with the Congress, it shows that, you know, given Karnataka's tendency to vote against the incumbent government, the BJP in Karnataka has failed miserably to build any kind of a campaign in its favor till Narendra Modi came. Isn't that true? Isn't there something to worry about for us people in Karnataka if it's okay, such a talentless party?
Let me try to articulate a reply to what you have said. But with permission of Karthikeya, can I reply to what Adil said? Because Adil said very objectionable things.
No, no, you can reply to Adil and then you can answer. Yes, yes, you can reply to Adil and then you can go back to Prakash Bilwadi.
Yeah. Yeah. You see, Karthike, we must draw a line and we must be logical when we say something. You see, if I have committed murder, will you hang my brother? Will you say that my brother is also a criminal? If Janardhan Reddy is criminal, we have no links with him. Should we deny ticket to his brothers who were MLAs earlier also? And there is no case against them. If we consider them winnable, should we deny ticket to them just because his brother is a criminal?
No, and this is a
slippery slope. So is the case with Srimalu. You see, he is MP of the BJP. Mm. You create an impression and then based on that impression you condemn that man. This thing would not be allowed in this country. You have to be convicted, some cases have to be filed because impression is created by media. And I'm coming to the second question. This impression is also created by media that we would not be winning Karnataka. Who said? We were prepared. Our Adhyakshji actually travelled 57,000 kilometers in Karnataka.
41,000.
And he had all the booth level meetings. No, 57,000, corrected.
Oh, all right, sir.
And he addressed all the booth level workers. Booth level workers. So the ground was prepared. We would have won in any case.
Sure.
But nobody can deny that when PM Modi campaigns, it becomes an icing on the cake. Yeah,
but saying everything.
Absolutely,
because,
don't.
Because we get certain to victory, but at the same time, the media creates an impression because the media doesn't want the BJP to win.
Which media are you talking
about?
Media is not a monolith.
The fence-eaters, they would feel that the Congress is strong.
All right, sir.
I'm not talking about WION. I'm not talking of your channel. I'm talking of majority of media.